Good afternoon. This is Dr. James Joyce, professor of geology at the University of Puerto Rico and Mayagüez, and consultant for the British Virgin Island Department of Disaster Management. I'm going to speak a bit about the earthquakes that have been occurring in the southwestern portion of Puerto Rico that have caused severe damage in several areas and a minor loss of lives, but still serious. These earthquakes have been occurring since December 28th. They've been fairly strong. They're in an area that we recognized as possible for producing earthquakes, but have never produced major earthquakes before. The earthquakes that have occurred started out what we thought was fairly strong, and there would be continued aftershocks. We're talking about 4.5 to 5 in the end of December. We expected these earthquakes would continue to drop off in terms of numbers and their magnitude, but this earthquake system has been very difficult to study. They've actually gotten stronger. Though there's been less earthquakes, we've now had two very large earthquakes, 5.8 yesterday, and then today, this morning at 4:43, 6.4. And not something that we expect, given the realms of things, certainly not something that was predicted. But the one thing that we do know is that you cannot predict earthquakes. And this is our big problem. We expect these things to happen because we know that once every century since the 1600s, we've had major destructive earthquake somewhere in the area of Puerto Rico and the Virgin Islands. The last one was 101 years ago off of northwestern Puerto Rico. It was a 7.5, extremely damaging, very strong earthquake that produced a major tsunami that resulted in losses of lives. The one prior to that was in the Virgin Island territory, south of St. Thomas, between St. Thomas and St. Croix. Also a magnitude 7.5, extreme ground shaking and damages, as well as a major tsunami that impacted the port in Charlotte Amalie and Frederickstead, St. Croix. This is part of our history. This is part of what we live in. We live in a very complex plate boundary, which is not just bound by one major fault system to the north, but a system of fault systems that separate Puerto Rico and the Virgin Islands away from the rest of the Caribbean plate, the Caribbean area, and as to the west, the Dominican Republic. And these faults are all occurring within the plate boundary zone, so all around Puerto Rico and the Virgin Islands. So now we have had this large earthquake. What does it mean? We don't really know what it means. We can't completely predict anything about this. Earthquakes are not like that. They work the way they want. Nature works in different ways. They work on time scales beyond the data sets that we actually have. And so while there's this big earthquake, and yes, it's like the earthquake, one of the earthquakes we might have expected to happen within this century and that we were due for, that does not mean that an earthquake cannot happen anywhere else at any time from now on. And we could still have a very large earthquake close to the Virgin Islands, or north of us in the Puerto Rico Trench. We have no way of determining that. What can we do? Prepare ourselves as if tomorrow is possible. Because we cannot plan ahead of time. There was no warning for earthquakes. This earthquake had a bunch of warnings, but we didn't know they were warnings. So there's not like a hurricane. We just all survived a major hurricane, but we were warned. We knew it was coming. The earthquake is not going to say it's coming. It's going to be here, and if you're not prepared, it's going to catch you unprepared. So the important issue here is prepare now. Get ready. Prepare your home. Prepare a plan. Teach your children and your family how to react during an earthquake. Because when it happens instantaneously. So it's really important to have a plan, to have a preparation, very similar to what you would do for a hurricane, except you have to be ready. There's no time. You have to get it ready now and have it prepared. When it happens, you'll be ready. So that's all we can really do with this. So I wish you all the best.